Three bike builders. Three nations. 5 weeks. One goal. To be crowned the greatest bike builder in the world. Englishman Russell Mitchell is well on track.
I build the bikes I want, and anyone who doesn't like it, they're wrong.
But there's a long way to go before the bike will be ready for Judgment Day.
I've just had a tack crack.
Australian Scotty Cox is thinking outside the box.
A lot of the Yank bikes, they follow the same theme all the time.
Oh. It's gonna be stuffed how they get man on the moon.
But he's had supply problems.
We have the invoice, but we have no wheels.
American Joe Martin has taken a big gamble.
Man, it doesn't feel really good to cut up a high-dollar front end like this.
Will it pay off?
Herman Munster, man.
I know, it's just like, whoa.
A contest of nations. Build a radical bike and have it judged by bike fans at Rats Hole Daytona.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are here for the World Biker Build-Off.
There's only 14 days to go. Who will win the first World Biker Build-Off? It's day 21, and down in Texas, Joe Martin has just finished the most radical front end he's ever built. It's a custom Springer. It could be a big mistake.
What do you think? It's just a little late, but I just don't think it should be that long.
With just 2 weeks to go, it's time to make a decision.
Marky, what do you think? We'll either use this front end or we have to cut the Springer down because it's just too long.
I said we cut the Springer.
Engineer Mark Juarez wants to modify the Springer.
To me, it looks too nostalgic, and then the rest of the bike's got all this funky flame stuff going on, you know?
It just didn't look right with it. The stretch and rake and the down tube, that sort of thing, is just a weird clashing. I mean, I like stuff to clash, but not, you know, that way.
It was just kind of funny looking. It took away from the project, you know, pretty heavily.
And I was running out of time, and I just wanted to go with what I knew would definitely look good.
Joe makes the call. The Springer's coming off.
We ended up going with the standard front end. The Y-Glide front end just looks a little beefier, looks a little more sleek. There's a time and place for a Springer, and that just wasn't it.
Switching to a shop stock front end means they've blown a whole week's work. The stress is starting to show.
I can't mess with my bars, so I get the tank done.
All right.
I mean, I can do it. I'm just running out of time. I just need some help, man. I can't get your ass off the phone. I just don't have time, you know?
Joe needs a team effort, but most of the fabrication is his alone. He begins working on the fuel tank. Without it, the rest of the bike can't be finished. The pressure is on.
I gotta try to make everything accommodate aesthetically, so I'll start forming this backbone and I'll build the tank around this backbone. So, and then hopefully it'll flow into this, the rest of the bike. We'll start making the sides of this thing. I'm trying to mix a little old with the new. Unfortunately, it didn't work with the front end, but hopefully it'll work with this tank. Fuel capacity is not going to be very much, but it is a hardtail. By the time it runs out of gas, I'll be ready to pull over and let my take a rest anyway, so. Here's my top piece of the tank. And as crude as this will actually be a really nice flowing piece. I got my side panel all finished. It's been beaten on the shop bag and rolled through the English wheel. So this piece is actually finished out, ready to weld on. And so this top will come right here, and the side will eventually mate to the top of this right here. And then I'll make opposing sides and weld them all up. And I should have my tank finished.
But there's another headache around the corner. The motor hasn't arrived, and they're just 13 days from Daytona.
Sancho, where's the motor?
Man, I talked to Robbie. He said it should be by Wednesday, by today.
Well, Joe's getting pretty pissy about it.
He said it'd be here. I mean, I'll call him up.
All I need to know is if it's going to come or not, because if it's not going to get here, I need to make other arrangements.
All right, man. Give him a ring up.
Look at that. Note the beautiful way the gap at the back of the seat matches the gap at the front of the seat. It's like classic, mate.
3 weeks into the build, and the English bike is in good shape, but there is still one vital part missing. So far, they have been building around a dummy motor.
All right, finally.
Now the real thing has arrived.
Wow. What was worth the wait? Man, that looks pretty bad.
It's a replica 1930s Harley-Davidson knucklehead, a classic.
But yeah, it's gonna look cool.
Question is, will it fit?
Oh, man. We aren't gonna be able to use our top motor man in there in a million years. I was hoping we might be able to machine it or something, but these things are miles apart. We're gonna have to make something that comes from here, bolts onto that guy. And I can't see any other way around it, man. That's what we gotta do. Let's get some quarter inch. Yeah, let's get some quarter inch. Grab a piece of cardboard. Let's get that sucker going.
Dylan gets to work on a new mounting point. The frame is due in the paint shop, and the clock is ticking. Meanwhile, Russell has another problem.
We don't have the room to put our regular pipe position in, so we're gonna have to make something, make a special header that comes down from here, goes under the front of the motor, and actually sneaks out through this gap in here between the motor and the frame. So we wanna do that, and then turns into the nice fat tailpipe that we're looking to achieve along here to parallel this guy that's gonna be up here.
It's not what Russell expected. Time for a radical rethink.
The pipes were something completely different because of the position of the exhaust ports. We had to get some major one-off bends and really come off with a special set of pipes. Well, we haven't done a knucklehead before, so it's all a whole learning deal for us.
It may be turning into a big knuckle headache, but the motor is crucial to Russell's plans.
Well, the bike we're doing is gonna have a real sort of retro hot rod feel. So rather than putting in a modern motor, we went for something old school. And in my opinion, the knuckle's one of the better looking motors that Harley ever came out with. It's still 103 cubic inch, you know, should be a fire-breathing monster. It should hold this thing up the road real nice. So, looking forward to hearing it run. I think this is gonna do it, man.
Hey, he's gone.
Hey, Johnny. What are you doing, man?
Hey, Jono.
Got that part, man?
Hey, y'all, mate.
In Australia, Scotty's been sweating on a delivery from the Cromer, 200 miles away. His handcrafted exhaust pipes.
It's a pipe, mate.
Ooh, let's have a look at that.
It better be good. At that distance, there are no returns.
Oh, she's wrapped up in the nice soft girl's dress, isn't that? This is the magic bit we've been waiting for. What do you reckon, mate?
Pretty flash.
Still fits. Sometimes when you chrome steel, it changes shape a little. That still fits good. I'm very happy with these exhaust pipes. Well, it's a two-in-one sort of thing. They're great. That's just unreal. I'm a happy camper.
The pipe is one of the few parts on the bike to be chromed. Everything else will be polished, beaten alloy.
It's kind of ironic that we're trying to build the best bike in the world and doing it the way they would have beat metal 1,000 years ago.
Scotty forms his alloy around a hand-carved wooden mold.
We do this way because it saves spending thousands of dollars on molds when you can just carve something out of a bit of wood, shape some alloy over it, and you've got any shape you want.
The alloy bodywork is coming together.
Ryan, you got me in the head.
But something's not quite right with the taillight design. Scotty asks his wife, Kylie, for a female point of view.
What don't you like about it, though?
I just don't like the shape.
Do you like that bit up the back or just the bottom part of the guard?
No, it's too many curves. I'll rub it off and draw something else. Look out, Snoop.
The backer of the bike is due in 2 days for an inspection. Scotty needs to get this fixed.
I like that better. I do like it better than the first one that you had.
You happy with that?
Yep, and I like it shorter.
Good enough to win?
Definitely good enough to win.
A little treat for Russell, just to be a good friend.
The American team is now way behind schedule.
You know, the color brings out the end, don't you think? The patriotic scene.
But Jason still finds time for some psychological warfare with his English rival in L.A.
Pretty expensive living out there. Need everybody help they can get, probably.
It's a single can of matte black paint. Meanwhile, Joe makes up for lost time.
I like my fenders kind of short, but I like a little bit of metal on the side, because from the side of the bike, it looks a little naked if there's not much fender on there. But it looks cool looking down on the bike if there's a lot of it cut out. Well, I think that's about it.
I just thought you might look at it a bit more, maybe.
You could argue with how I style my bikes, man.
No, I'm not gonna argue. He always ends up looking good.
Yeah.
Sometimes he'll draw something out and it looks so crazy to me when I see it. I'm like, yeah, I don't know.
It sucks.
By the time it's done, it always looks a hell of a lot better than I could ever imagine it looking.
Well, I think that's about it. It won't be much for keeping rain and mud off, but it'll look good.
In contrast to the radical fender, the oil tank is traditionally mounted under the seat.
Got to make this seat pan conform to the lines of this frame right here. The seat will actually look like it's down inside the bike, and it'll also provide stability. The seat won't move around.
With Joe hard at work on the bike, brother Jason is busy keeping up his end of the business.
I just want to try to get it at this angle. I think it probably looked best like that. You know what I'm looking for. You tell me how you want it and just kind of do your thing from there.
But one of the things I want to do is create an environment as if she's in the shop and it's a hot day.
The one thing, though, I don't want to lose is focus of the bike.
On the bike.
On the bike being in the shot, too.
Strike a pose.
Jason has organized a calendar shoot. The publicity is needed even in the middle of a frantic bike build.
Got a new name for the shop, man. I'm gonna call it Joe Martin, the brother.
Any other time, this would be a welcome distraction. But not today. Not with 12 days to go.
Okay, great.
So these have just been sandblasted, right?
These have been sandblasted.
Russell Mitchell's bikes come in any color.
Not into that.
As long as it's black.
You're going to have the nicest bikes on the block.
But for the World Biker Build-Off, he's making one concession.
For this particular show, we wanted to come up with something that we thought would appeal to, you know, the people out there.
Of course, the bike will be black, but the wheels? Red rims with white wall tires.
If I painted that bike in sky blue metal flake, I would triple the vote. But I'm not going to do it. That isn't what I put my name to, and I'm not going to do it just to win this contest.
How long are they in the oven for?
About 10 minutes. And it'll be hard when it comes out of the oven. It'll be hard to the touch. You could dig your nail into it, but it's basically done. So we can pull them out, and you can check those if you want.
Yeah, I'll hang around. I just want to see them, make sure that we're dead on with the red.
Okay.
I know we're not going to have the semi-gloss on it. And then we'll get out of here, start putting the frame together. I'll send Jake over in the morning. Boom, we'll have wheels by lunchtime.
Perfect.
Cool.
Look at that. That's just an awesome color. More time on light parts, it takes less time.
Russell's other crowd pleaser will be the paint job on the tank. For that, he needs a specialist.
Well, we're at Miguel's Cycle Paint. Miguel's a good friend of mine. He paints all our sheet metal. He's a good guy. He does a great job. I've come over here myself because we're about to lay out the flames for the tank, and I want to make sure he does it just the way I want it. You know how I like them, short and fat. So what I want, Miguel, is I want the front to be completely white, and then the tips of the flames I want to be this silver. This is the oil filter that came off the knucklehead motor we've got. And it'd be great if we could tie the silver off of this into the tips of the flames.
All right.
This bike, Miguel, is the English team's offering in a sort of international bike build contest, mm-hmm. and the American team are the Martin brothers, and I've heard they like to cut costs by trying to paint their own bikes, but you know, we prefer to use the professionals, man. Wow.
This is the fun part.
Cool. Bet them Martin brothers don't have any of that. Hey, check this out, boys. Technology. Professionals, mate, that's how we do it. I love it, I love it. Yeah, it's gonna be so cool because this white is gonna pick up on the white walls because the white walls like pop like that. And then the red will tie in with the red rims. It's really gonna be the finishing touch.
Russell brought two tanks for painting. One to get flames for the build-off, and another to be painted black for a customer named Melanie. It could be one tank too many.
This is not the gas cap for Melanie's tank because Melanie's tank has flames on it now.
He's painted the wrong tank.
Either I wrote all the flame instructions, well, according to Miguel here, I wrote the flame instructions on Melanie's tank, which seems highly unlikely because we shipped them on the same day.
Yeah.
Or screwed up, you know what I mean?
Which is
as if, you know?
Miguel has to start all over again. In the down-under town of Urala, Scotty Cox is grinding out a bike to do his nation proud.
That's pretty good. Yeah.
But first, he has to please its owner.
Nice front end.
Today, his financial backer is coming to inspect progress. Scotty wants the bike to look its best.
We're going to bolt our wheels on now. That's the fun part. Once we've got wheels on it, it's going to look like something.
The setback of the lost wheels is behind him, and now Scotty likes what he sees.
Starting to look like something now. Something wicked.
But what will the client think? It's showtime.
Hey, Scotty.
G'day, mate.
Oh, look at that.
How are you, mate? Good. How you going? G'day, Jay.
That's the business, isn't it?
Yeah, how you doing?
Good. Wow. You have been busy, haven't you? Hey?
Greg Shepherd runs East Coast Customs in Brisbane, one of the biggest dealers in the country. His opinion counts, so it's a big moment for Scotty and the boys.
What are we going to paint this or polish it?
We're going to polish it. We're going to paint the frame.
Yeah.
It'll be candy apple red or close to.
Yeah, yeah.
And all the rest will be polished. So the red will break it up.
Yeah.
Just in parts where you see the metal.
Hmm. There won't be any heat issues in here? Like you're sitting on it?
The seat will actually be higher because the battery lays there.
Just pack you up a little bit.
Will be,
It'll have ample clearance, yeah. That's a full fuel tank, it's not just a cover.
That's the full tank.
Mate, I think you've about done yourself, actually. Well, you sort of got to get back a little bit to sort of take it all in because it's just almost too much. I think that's probably the most awesome custom motorcycle I've seen in my life. Being in the business for 20 years and seeing lots of motorcycles and lots of garages and lots of shops all over the place, this thing's breathtaking. I think this bike's got what it takes to win the World Biker Build Off, that's for sure. I think the American public are going to love this bike, and I think it's going to take out the number one spot.
With just 11 days left, the bike passes its first test. The reward? An afternoon off.
We're just going out the road to a 1,000-acre paddock where we know there's usually some roos in the scrub. Let's go and see if we can round a couple up.
Scotty calls it the Beast. He built it from the wreck of an old pickup truck, perfect for an afternoon drive, or as they say out here, bush bashing.
Here's a little touch-up paint for your bikes. Good luck, Jason. There you go, man. At least he's got the color scheme right. We should vomit in here, send it back, say, "Dear Jason, here's some paint for your bikes."
Russell's next delivery is far more useful.
That was probably the biggest event in the entire build. And we put flames on the wrong gas tank. He says I told him that that was the tank that was getting flames. I think it was a breakdown in Miguel's concentration. But anyway, we all had a jolly good laugh, and Miguel had to put some more flames on. Woo. Lovely paintwork in the house.
The English are now all set to start final assembly.
It's going beautifully. We need to stop when the brake line is where we want the brake line to be.
Simplicity rules. Electrical wires must remain strictly out of sight.
This guy's going to the starter switch long enough, and this one's going up here to the horn button. They could do it being a little bit. Might be a little bit snug. Your wire's a big part of the final assembly process, and our bikes are very simple, so we don't have a great deal of wiring. We don't have turn signals and stuff like that, adding to the complexity. That's what separates the good builders from the bad. It's really important to us that you can sleep at night with your wiring.
Russell's old buddy, Dave Hurley, has flown over from London to help out. There are just 10 days left.
Right, we're just mocking this up just to get the length of the tube right before I finish making this brake pipe up. When we normally put this fitting into the caliper, normally it tightens up just as this fitting is facing downwards. Just so happens that this one is facing upwards and we're too scared to tighten it anymore, so we're going to have to take it out, try a different fit, and if that's no good, we'll change to another cycle fit. Dad said to me once, if it won't come out, put it in. And if it won't get in, take it out.
front, just so we saved that, and the dab was right.
All right, you got it, dude?
Yeah.
I'm moving my hand. Spot him, Dave, because it's heavy, that sucker.
The troublesome knucklehead motor is installed for the last time.
In. Way to go, dude.
It fits perfectly on its custom mount. There's even time for more trash talk.
Do you know what the Australian flag is, Danny? You're smart.
The Australian flag? Oh, I suspect it's just one of ours they've ripped off, but not quite so good.
Yeah, I don't know anything about the Australian flag, but I trust it has a Union Jack in at least part of it.
Hey, look, mate, I got us a new flag.
Hey, beauty. Let's cut the Union Jack out and get a bit out of a Scottish Chopper T-shirt off the back and sew that in there. One
more time. I'm going to hoist her up.
Hoist her up.
Up she goes.
Scotty's business partner, Grant Perkis, is starting to feel a little patriotic.
This flag's been up there for over 12 months, and look at it, some halved in size. We're missing a few stars, and we're faded right out. The harsh Australian sun. We're proud to be Australians, down under, building the best bikes in the world, in the harshest conditions. We're winners. We're about to be unveiled to the world, just how good they are. Good, she's flying, there's wind. Looks better than the old one.
The Aussies are looking forward to flying the flag for their country. And to keep their spirits up, some of Scotty's friends swing by to root for the home team.
Oh, greatest invention I've come across, mate. Yeah, they are good.
You'd have to see it to believe it. You wouldn't know just how he makes them down the back there, out of virtually nothing.
The design and the look and the power, it's absolutely, you know, super.
Yeah, credit what he does, mate, isn't it? Credit to him. Yeah.
Oh, I want one.
If these fans can make it to Rat's Hole, the title could well be coming down under. But for now, fabrication continues on Scotty's alloy armor.
And that's it. This piece is the outside piece for the strut. It'll slip on the bike and that'll be one of the rear struts. We've encountered a little problem. We've tacked this little belt guard on, but the strut doesn't come off. We need to be able to get this off so we can polish it. I really hate having to cut things up once I put them together. But it's a damn sight easier to fix them now than on the other side of the world, I'll tell you. Because Americans seem to lack tools, welders, machine shops. It's gonna be stuffed how they get man on the moon.
There are just 10 days till Rat's Hole.
Well, I'm getting ready to pour the seat foam.
In Texas, they're breaking out the chemicals.
And you pour it in there and it goes to shape and puffs up like a cake. All right, 5 minutes.
You see a lot of guys, they have these big puffy, goofy seats. It kind of ruins the whole chopper thing, you know? I mean, because choppers bare essentials and you know, you can't be really that comfortable. And so you see these guys that are trying to be bad riding these choppers and they got this big dorky cushion. And it just looks goofy, you know? I mean, you know, to ride one of these bikes, you're gonna have to suffer a little bit. Oh, yeah. Let's try that out. Oh, yeah. My kidneys will appreciate this seat.
Sit on it, boo.
Wow. What he's not showing you is the pull up and tuck move that you usually have to do before you sit on one of these bikes. You know, you gotta, how do you say it delicately? You gotta position yourself correctly before you sit on it, because
sit on one of these bikes.
Yeah, if you brake too hard, you get what I'm saying.
Three teams from the US, England, and Australia are racing to complete their machines in time for Judgment Day. The Rat's Hole Show at Daytona Bike Week.
Are you ready?
What do you think?
Team USA lost 6 days building a front end that didn't work.
Put it back on.
Now the bike has a standard set of forks, and Joe Martin is a week behind. Russell and Team England finally received their classic knucklehead motor.
Well, it was worth the wait.
But they got more than they bargained for.
We aren't going to be able to use our top motor man in there in a million years.
Down under, Scotty Cox's small Team Australia was sweating on an inspection by the bike's financial backer.
I think that's probably the most awesome custom motorcycle I've seen.
The customer is happy, and now they need to finish their bike in time to ship it the 10,000 miles to Daytona. The English are now well into their assembly, and Russell is lacing up.
I hear them other guys are using billet wheels, and I'm pretty sure that that is just because they're not skillful enough to lace their own wheels. Because you gotta be a true craftsman for this, man. Not any Tom, Dick, and Harry can do it.
Old school Russell gives a lesson in wheel design.
Getting all these spokes positioned just so is key to an easy lace. We're gonna drop the rim right over it. They're all gonna line up with the spoke hold. Nipple goes in, done deal.
Or maybe not. The spokesmaster has struck a problem.
You gotta index the spokes. So the spoke that goes that way on one side is just in front of the spoke that goes that way on the other side. I got to put the spokes in the wrong indexing. There's two ways they can relate to each other. One way's right, one way's wrong, and I put them in the wrong way around. This is my sexy red wheel with powder-coated rims. I'm gonna put the tire on it. I'm too scared to put it on the tire machine because I don't want to risk scratching this beautiful red stuff, so I'm gonna put the tire on with my bare hands. Uno, dos, tres. One side.
Now, you know, then again, I can modify these probably.
The American build is now way behind schedule. Joe wants to speed things up. He's modified some shop handlebars.
I don't like those bars.
You do?
You don't?
Let's do something different.
Man, I know these bars aren't gonna work. It's just I already had them made for that dude, and I could probably cut them, you know?
Yeah, but it wouldn't be that hard to make new ones. I got the slugs are the hardest thing to make.
Yeah, but I mean,
I got a bunch of those already made.
This is already made here.
Okay.
I mean, why not just cut them here and just add on?
I know I'm getting down to the wire on this bike, but I hate to cop out, you know, just to save myself a little bit of time.
What are you gonna do now?
Maybe that long piece like we were talking about?
Yeah.
Thought that'd be kind of cool. I like that little jog, it looks bad, you know?
You just don't want your bars to look like an afterthought.
Yeah, I don't think they will, but if something wasn't a bitch, it'd be wrong, you know what I mean? Marky, man, where you sneaking off to, boy?
Man, what are you talking about?
Man, I'm gonna change the name of the shop to Joe Martin the Brother Bikes.
You can. As long as I get paid, I don't know.
Because, man,
I'm changing the name.
My brothers aren't helping me.
I'm sorry I can't stay tonight. I have a prior engagement.
What do you got to do?
I'm gonna go see the Lakers play tonight.
What? You gonna go see the Lakers?
Yeah, the Mavericks are
playing. Are you going?
No.
Man, how come I don't get those tickets, man? So. Man, you guys will never let me go to a game, man.
You can go to a game. You can go to a game.
In the end, Joe's got no game and no bars.
Man, what a boy.
My bar sucks.
Damn. That's too far, man. Might as well rest my chin on the tank, you know? Build me a little pad right here for my chin.
Joe's quick fix isn't working.
That sucks.
His patience has run out.
And I'm gonna call it a night, man. See if I can conjure up some other idea in my wild dreams, I guess. I don't know. It's about to get me about half, so I probably just need to step away from it for a while.
On the other side of the world, Scotty Cox is also building bars.
I'm gonna bend this piece and then cut it up and see if I can make something.
Being alloy, it's not as strong as steel, so it has to be much thicker. I think that's about as much bend as I'll get without wrinkling it. We've got a pretty good bend there, so it's nice and uniform here. Our handlebars should end up something like this. I'm just going to have to keep them high enough so they come over the tank when we turn.
Six days in the making, the Aussie bike gets some finishing touches.
Okay, we'll do something else there.
Just looks a little bit fat at the back. I'll be happy with that.
Cool.
You'd have to be happy with that. I'm pretty exhausted after all these days of working day and night to get this thing done, but I'm relieved it's going off to the paint shop and we get to have a little break before the assembly, which is going to be full on again. I'm happy that it's all turned out so well and it's turned out on time and it's turned out the best bike in the world.
Today's the big day we've been waiting for. Frame's going into paint. It's 7 a.m, it's a beautiful day for it. A friend in Armidale's kindly donated the booth for us to paint in. I can't wait to see how it looks.
Everyone on the Aussie team has turned out for the occasion. The frame gets a base of silver, followed by layers of red, until the color is just right.
I'll put, say, one coat on, or two coats, or three coats, then Scotty's gonna come in and have a look. He'll just say, stop. That's the effect I want.
I'm happy, mate.
Yeah, it's probably just on the verge now. If I go any further, it's gonna go black.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't go any darker than that.
Right.
Billy looks like a bought one now. Carry on.
Clear him up.
Clear him up.
It's looking good, looking real good. A bit of colour makes all the difference.
I like Scotty's bikes, they are good. Like, there's nothing else like it. Like, once you have a look at one of his bikes, you'll know that there's nothing else like it.
Back in LA, the English assembly powers ahead. With 8 days to go, the team is well on the way to winning the race to Rat's Hole. Russell moves to the front end. Another example of his simple philosophy.
So I'm a super minimalist, and I love the cleanliness. So basically, our whole quest is to make the bike cleaner and cleaner. We want rideability, maintainability, but we want that super clean bike. And I think we nailed that niche.
Simplicity is not the only niche Russell has nailed. The bike's hand gear shift has an extra special feature.
What this line lock does is it sits on the end of my gear shift lever. Here's one I made earlier. And when you're at the top of a hill and you can't take the foot off the brake because you have no separate front brake or you'll roll backwards into the car, this line lock holds the front brake on so you can take your foot off the brake, put your foot on the clutch, stick it into first and pull away, a little bit like your stick shift car.
It's day 27 in Dallas, and Joe still has his handlebar crisis.
The problem with the bars is I didn't want to sacrifice style for function, you know, and have some goofy set of bars.
Joe thinks he has the answer.
All right, Tom, twist it. I'm gonna say right about there.
He has cut back the risers and welded the bars at a lower angle, missing the tank.
It was just finally a couple days of messing with it, you know, with the taking pieces of tube and trying to get it right, and just couldn't get it right, and I just, you know, called it a night. And the next day I came in and hit it right on, and they turned out pretty cool. Damn, that's pretty close, man.
It does look good, doesn't it?
Joe may not be getting the forks he originally planned, but the handlebars are pure Martin Brothers.
Here's a finely tuned piece to make right here.
Never a man for understatement, his front end will be a mass of chrome and points, from hub to hand controls.
I've always kind of been into the, you know, a lot of the points and stuff. I've been doing that lately on my bikes. I thought this would just be something different. What I'm gonna do is try and point these things out a little bit, kind of like devil horns or something.
Joe's love of chrome is matched only by his love of paint. He has big plans, but will he have time to get it done? In Daytona Beach, Florida, the first of 500,000 fans are arriving for Bike Week. It's huge exposure for the teams in the World Biker Build-Off. Failure is not an option. Confidence is high in the British camp. The bike is set to be finished with time to spare. Down under, there's an extra hurdle. How to get their bike safely all the way to Florida. Rat's Hole, just 8 days away. In Australia, the pressure is intense. The team has a unique problem.
We're trying to make the crate so that the bike can't get damaged inside the crate, even to a point where if they drop it, the bike shouldn't get damaged.
They must ship their bike halfway around the world. Scotty's old protege, Craig Faulkner, has come to help out.
It's hard to see something you've put so much work into just being shipped off overseas in a little steel crate, and you don't even know if it's going to get the other end.
But shipping's not the only problem. Before assembly, there's one huge job to do.
We go to so much trouble to get the aluminium all smooth and straight so we can polish it. There's no need for Bondo, or bog as we call it over here. With my bikes, what you see is what you get. There's no filler of any type. It's all metal, and they're forever.
That's pretty much how this turns out after we polish. It's a terrible, dirty, stinking job, and I don't really like it much, but it's a price you pay for making cool bikes with no bog. Bondoing sucks, man. But you gotta do it.
With only 7 days to go, the American medal is finally done. From front end to fender, Joe Martin is a happy man.
I didn't mean to do that.
Next, his most radical paint job ever.
Steels, after you weld it, you know, you're gonna get high and low spots. You know, you pound on it, beat on it, you know, the best you can, get it pretty smooth, but you're still gonna have to put a little mud in it. Just sucks getting to that point. It'll be worth it, man. You know, the competition's English guys and Australians, right? And the English guys, I didn't know they could build motorcycles as fish and chips or something.
You know? Yeah, I mean,
fish and chips and Australians, they're a bunch of cast-off criminals. Yeah. Right? Isn't that the deal?
Yeah.
See, I think you're wasting your time.
Yeah.
Let's see what you got, boo.
The Martin brothers are building the bike they always dreamed of. But even now, just days from deadline, they still can't decide what it's going to look like.
What's gonna be the color? You gonna use both of them?
Nah, it's gonna be one or the other. I just can't decide what I wanna do. I got basically 2 days to finish
green.
The paint.
Green. Go with the green.
You want green? I want this color. But I really don't have to agree with anything you like. No reason for me to do that. Why would I start now? You know?
So I tell you what, I'll flip you.
All right, flip. What do you got?
Head's gold, tail's green.
Head's gold, tail's green.
Yeah.
Dylan, wanna give me a hand a second, man? Come and hold this side and let me take a look.
In California, the English bike comes together like clockwork until a clutch cable stops the build.
Holy. Now that's a real problem. We have a time crunch here. Now this is retardedly long. I can't believe I ordered it that long. So we need a double quick time, so I gotta go call them right now because I'm sure I measured it right, but you never know. Even God gets it wrong. This is Russell with Exile Cycles. A few weeks ago, I ordered 3 custom cables. Okay, 23.5 inches. Center length of cable, 23.5 inches, and I received 3. 30 inches. No use to us. Can't put transmission fluid in, we can't button it up, we can't run it, we can't ride it, we can't do anything without a clutch. We are under a time crunch. Whip one of these out double quick time. Damn! So that we can get this bike finished and you won't be the reason for our failure.
6 days left. It's the final sprint to Rat's Hole.
Where the hell's Joe at?
Reputations are on the line.
Joe can about things, but you definitely can't about what he does.
3 countries are racing against the clock.
These guys reckon they had the right brake lines, but they haven't.
Mistakes are proving costly.
It's no good without brakes.
5 weeks of hard work has come down to this.
Damn.
Who will make it and who will win?
Who is the greatest bike builder of the world?
On the next episode of the World Biker Build-Off.